Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Gitasha Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 24th of May. Pushpa Kamal Dahal resigns as Nepal Prime Minister. Six Indian fishermen arrested for poaching by Sri Lankan Navy. An Indian woman who claimed she was forced to marry Pakistani man allowed to return home. And now for all the details. Nepal's Prime Minister Pushpa Kamal Dahal or Prachanda resigned on Wednesday during an address to the nation. Dahal was elected as the 39th Prime Minister of Nepal for the second time after forging alliance with the Nepali Congress on August 3, 2016. Dahal, who is also the chairman of CPN-Maoist Center, had reached an understanding with the Nepali Congress that he would step down from PM's post and hand over the government leadership to Nepali Congress President Sher Bahadur Deuba after 9 months. Deuba is likely to be the next prime minister. Staying on news from Nepal, with no progress in sight for the demands of constitution amendment being addressed, Madhes-based Rashtriya Janata Party on Wednesday held a protest meet threatening the government to boycott the second phase of local elections.
Nepal's Rashtriya Janata Party or the RJP leaders on Tuesday held a protest meet threatening to boycott the second phase of local elections slated to be held on June 14. The protesters said no polls will be allowed to be conducted in the Madhes-populated areas until the government reforms the constitution. RJP leaders said that if a favorable environment is not created for fulfillment of their demand of constitution amendment, then the polls cannot commence under any circumstances.
ये दबाव है कि बिना हमारा मांग संबोधन किए हुए चुनाव की बात मत करो आंदोलन की बात करो तो जिस बात के लिए बरसों लड़ा है इतना शहादत हुआ है वो मांग पूरा नहीं हो पाया है इसलिए मांग जब तक पूरा नहीं होता है आंदोलन में रहना चाहिए चुनाव की बात नहीं होनी चाहिए ये जन दबाव है
द मदेसीज आर डिमांडिंग अमेंडमेंट्स इन द प्रोविजन ऑफ सिटीजनशिप इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डिलिनिएशन इज देयर प्राइमरी डिमांड बिफोर द सेकंड फेज ऑफ पोल्स आर हेल्ड
Meanwhile, Sri Lankan Navy on Tuesday arrested six Indian fishermen and impounded their boat for allegedly fishing illegally in its waters. A report.
Six Indian fishermen were arrested and their boat was impounded by Sri Lankan Navy on Tuesday for allegedly fishing illegally in its waters. The Sri Lankan Navy confirmed the arrests in a statement on its official website. The fishermen are due to be handed over to the Jaffna Assistant Fisheries Director for onward legal action, said the statement.
மாவரம் மாவட்டத்தைச் சேர்ந்த நம்புதாலை கிராமத்தைச் சேர்ந்த நாட்டுப்படகு மீனவர்கள் இன்னைக்கு 6 பேரை இலங்கை கடற்படையினர் கைது செய்து இலங்கை சிறையில் அடைச்சிருக்காங்க. இது முன்னாடி எல்லாம் என்ன சொல்வாங்கன்னு சொன்னா தமிழ்நாட்டில் இருக்கக்கூடிய விசைப்படகுகள் இலங்கை கடலோரங்கள்ல வந்து அந்த பகுதியில் வந்து தடை செய்யப்பட்ட வலைகளையும் அத்துமீறிய மீன்பிடிப்பையும் செய்றாங்க. இதனால இலங்கை மீனவர்களுக்கு பாதிப்பு வருதுன்னு சொல்லி இவ்வளவு நாள் சொன்னாங்க. ஆனால் அவன் இன்னைக்கு என்னன்னு சொன்னா மரபு சார்ந்து மீன் பிடிக்கக்கூடிய சாதாரண நாட்டுப்படகு மீனவர்களை இன்னைக்கு கைது பண்ண
Fishermen from both countries frequently stray into each other's territory and end up spending years in jails. India shares an expansive oceanic border with Sri Lanka without any perceptible demarcation, and fishermen on both sides ignore rules while netting their catch. The UN Convention on the Law of the Sea states that fishermen who cross territorial waters can be warned and fined but not arrested.
At least 20 pilgrims were killed and another 6 injured in India's northern Uttarkashi district on Tuesday evening as the bus they were travelling in fell into a river.
A bus carrying pilgrims to India's northern Uttarkashi district fell into Bhagirathi River late on Tuesday evening, killing at least 20 and injuring 6 persons. Reportedly, the driver lost control of the vehicle due to separation of a tire from the bus, causing the vehicle to overturn. The bus then fell into the 250 meters deep river. Search operations are underway to locate the last one pilgrim who remains missing.
अभी हम एक व्यक्ति जो है उसको हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि और ढूंढा जाए लेकिन अभी इसके अलावा भी हम रेस्क्यू ऑपरेशन कुछ और देर तक भी चलाएंगे जिससे कि अगर कोई भी कहीं भी हो तो वो हमें
अभी तक कितनी डेड बॉडी
हमें 20 डेड बॉडीज अभी तक रिकवर हुई
अ प्रोब हैज बीन ऑर्डर्ड इनटू द इंसिडेंट
Moving on to news from Pakistan, an Indian national, Uzma Ahmed, who was reportedly married off to a Pakistani man and was stuck there, was given permission to travel to India by Islamabad High Court on Wednesday. According to reports, the High Court also ordered the police to provide security to her till Wagha border. Uzma, who alleged she was forced to marry her husband at gunpoint, had submitted a reply in Islamabad High Court asking that she be allowed to return to India. Soon after the hearing, Uzma left the court for the Indian High Commission, where she will reportedly stay until she is sent back. More news from Pakistan. Days after the International Court of Justice stayed death sentence given to former Indian naval officer Kulbhushan Jadhav by Pakistani military court, Pakistan's National Assembly Speaker has said that country will forcefully present its case during the next hearing.
Pakistan's National Assembly Speaker Sardar Ayaz Sadiq has said that Pakistan will forcefully present its case on Indian citizen Kulbhushan Jadhav during the next hearing at the International Court of Justice or ICJ scheduled for June 8. Sadiq made the remarks on Tuesday after a meeting of the Parliamentary Committee on National Security discussed Pakistan's performance at ICJ. The committee was unhappy over the Pakistani government's explanations about the performance of the legal team in Jadhav case. The primary judicial organ of the United Nations on May 18th told Pakistan to take all possible measures to ensure that Jadhav is not executed and give consular access to India. Jadhav was awarded the death sentence by a Pakistan military court on April 10th for alleged espionage and subversive activities. India, whose request for consular access to Jadhav was turned down 16 times, had approached the ICJ on May 8th.
With an aim to bring laurel to the country, a group of Afghan judokas on Tuesday left Kabul for Japan to attend the Asian Judo Championship 2017 in Hong Kong.
A four-member team, including three men and one woman, along with their coach and advisor on Tuesday, left Kabul for Japan to attend the Asian Judo Championship 2017 in Hong Kong. At least 48 countries will participate at the event, which will start on May 26. The judo athletes have been training for months now. They hoped their hard training brings good results to the country.
ورزشکارای ما چهار تن از سه تن از بچه هاست یکی از دخترا تقریبا چهار ماه آمادگی خاص گرفتن به این مسابقات که یک نتیجه بسیار عالی داشته باشند.
ما تا حد توان تا حد که امکانات به پیش ما بود ما تمرین کردیم. سطح مسابقه بلند است بسیار از مسابقات قبلا اشتراک کردیم.
This is not the first time that Afghan athletes are venturing outside their country to participate in big events. Several have in the past, and on May 13, three Afghan judokas attended the Islamic Solidarity Games in Baku, Azerbaijan.
India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province boasts of a rich theatrical history which finds mention in ancient literary texts. An ongoing theatre festival in the summer capital of the province is entertaining residents.
A folk theatre festival in Srinagar city of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir province is enthralling audiences. Residents have been thronging Srinagar's Tagore Hall to witness the spectacular performances. The eight-day-long festival, organized by the Academy of Art, Culture and Language, is staging different plays in Kashmiri and other languages. Inaugurated on May 17th, the festival aims to revive the dying art of folk theatre and make people aware about its importance.
आप जानते हैं कि हमारे यहाँ थिएटर की एक लंबी और एक पावरफुल ट्रेडिशन है
بانڈ پتھر کو لے کر ہم بہت ہی فخر سے کہہ سکتے ہیں کہ یہ ایک ایسا فوک تھیٹر ہے جو دنیا کے پاورفل فوک تھیٹرز کے ساتھ مقابلہ کر سکتا ہے۔
ہر ایک سوسائٹی میں اپنی اپنی ایک کوئی نہ کوئی ضرورت ہوتی ہے تھیٹر کی۔ تھیٹر ہر وقت شیکسپیئر کے زمانے سے لے کر ٹائگور سے لے کر ہم کہیں گے کہ ہمارے کشمیر میں تھیٹر کی ہر وقت ضرورت ہے۔ تھیٹر تو ہر وقت ضرورت ہے۔ تھیٹر ہی سوسائٹی کی پہچان دیتا ہے پورے قوم کو، پورے ورلڈ کو۔
Theatre is an important part of Kashmiri culture and tradition and dates back to thousands of years. Such events help the people of the region to learn about their cultural roots. The festival will come to an end on Wednesday.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening before we conclude the top stories once again. Pushpa Kamal Dahal resigns as Nepal Prime Minister. Six Indian fishermen arrested for poaching by Sri Lankan Navy. And Indian woman who claimed she was forced to marry Pakistani man allowed to return home. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.